My space. What happened in the past that inspired you to work in the space industry?
I didn't think of space as a job when I was younger. I was only fascinated by space since I was somebody really interested in everything around science, and I was watching the sky and trying to understand what's up there in the infinite world. So that was my feeling, but I couldn't even dream one day to be part of the space adventure as with my working experience. So it has been gradually the move from my education, which was pretty much into mathematics, and then my first job, my first training course at the end of my college and university course, when I had the opportunity to go to helicopter industry, and helicopter industry was part of a bigger group which was also working around the space industry. And so my first job actually was to get into the space industry in a big satellite manufacturing company. But I would say I hadn't looked for going into this business, but once I had the opportunity to get into it, I was again fascinated by the nature of the very impressive things that's happening in this area.
How do you make a difference for people living on the planet Earth?
We are thinking wide, because you know, with a single asset, single satellite in space, you can reach hundreds of millions of people, and you can bring them the opportunity to receive television, communication, information. So the space originally is something most people don't know what it's all about, but most people use the space assets into their everyday life. So this is something difficult to describe. What's a satellite look like? You ask 10 people in the street, most of the people will not be able to tell you. But everybody is relying on space assets currently today.
Eric, we're in 2050. Mm-hmm. We look up in the sky. What do we see?
Okay. I think we still won't see satellites very clearly in the sky because they are really far away, but probably we will see many more planes, maybe UAVs as well, probably, most probably UAVs, and probably as well flying cars, I would imagine, or flying transportation like you're using your car every day.
Eric, thank you very much for your time today.
Thank you.